So in reply to that mode of yoga, Krishna is directly speaking here, Maya Saktamana. If you try to concentrate your mind on the form of Krishna, so beautiful, he is enjoying with Radharani and his associates, then Maya Saktamana part of yoga. If you practice this yoga, Madasaya Jinyan Madas, you have to practice this yoga. At the same time, you have to take shelter of Krishna. Mad Asraya. Asraya means under my protection. This is called surrender. If you go to a friend in a difficult position and you surrender to your friend, my dear friend, you are so great, so powerful, so influential, I am in this great danger, so I surrender unto you. You please give me protection. So, you can do that to Krishna. Here in the material world, if you surrender to a person, however very big he may refuse. He may say, well, I am unable to give you protection. That is the natural reply. If you are in danger, and if you go even to your intimate friend, please give me protection, he will hesitate, because his power is very limited. He'll first of all think that if I give protection to this person, whether my interest will not be jeopardized. He'll think like that, because his potency is limited. But Krishna is so nice, that he is so powerful, he is so opulent. He declares in the Bhagavad Gita, everyone, sarvadhanman parityajya mamekam saranam vraja. You leave aside everything, you simply surrender unto me. And what is the result? The result is, ahantam sarvapapibhva mukhaishyami. I shall get you released from all kinds of reaction of your sinful life. This material world, our activities, are all sinful activities. There is action and reaction. Whatever you are doing, there is action and reaction. Even there is good reaction, still it is sinful. Still it is sinful. Just like according to Vedic literature, the pious activities, the result of pious activity, janmai sajya suta srivhi. Suppose you are not acting anything sinful in this life, you are very pious in every respect. You are charitable. You are benevolent. Everything is all right. But Bhagavad Gita says that it is karma bandhana. If you give in charity somebody, say, some amount of money, you will get that money back 4 times, 5 times, or 10 times more in your next life. That is a fact. So, Vaishnava philosophy says that this is also sinful. Why sinful? Now because you have to take your birth to receive that compound interest. That is sinful. Now suppose you are born in a very rich family. The trouble of being in the womb of the mother, that is the same. Either you are pious man or the impious man. When you are in the womb of your mother, the difficulties and the pains perceived within the womb of the mother is the same. Either you are black or white, either you are Indian or American, or cat or dog or anyone. Janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha dosha darshana. The troubles of birth, the troubles of death, and the troubles of disease, and the troubles of old age are everywhere the same. It is not that because you are born in a very rich family, you will be immune from diseases. It is not that you will not become old. It is not that you will be saved from the troubles of birth or you will be saved from the troubles of death. So these things have to be understood very clearly. But people have become so unintelligent, they do not care for death, all right, death, let it come. But now especially in these days, a child is in the womb of the mother. So many killing processes are there. So many. Why? Because people are becoming so much entangled that such person even do not get birth. In the womb of the mother he is placed and he is killed. Again he is placed in another womb of mother. Again he is killed. In this way he does not see even the light. So to become in the womb of the mother and to again accept death, to accept old age, accept disease, is not very good business. If you are rich man, you have to accept all these troubles of material existence, or if you are poor man, it doesn't matter. Anyone who comes into this material world with this material body, he has to take all these troubles. It may be that you are American, the richest nation in the world. That does not mean there is no disease, there is no old age, there is no birth, there is no death. So the intelligent person is he who can make a solution of these problems. He is intelligent. Others who are making patchwork, patching, trying to make a solution of the problems of material life, although they are unable, it is not possible.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Krishna.